In today's video, I'll be showing you 10 things to do as soon as you get or update to Windows 11. The 10 tips I have will make sure you are ready for Windows 11, whether you're updating from Windows 10 or starting out on a new device. We'll cover all things from improving PC performance and sound quality to ensuring your devices and monitors are set up correctly. Use the chapters to navigate all of the methods, and remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the video. We'll begin by disabling any startup apps that you don't want or need in Windows 11. There might be some new apps that come with Windows 11 or others that you haven't used in a while. These apps will run automatically every time you boot into Windows and will slow down your PC as they use up your system's resources. You should notice a boost in performance and faster loading times if you turn off a few startup apps. To disable startup apps, head to the main settings page by searching for it. In the settings, click on Apps from the list of options on the left. In here, click on Startup, which should be the bottom option on the list. On the next page, you will see the list of apps and some will be turned on, which means they will run at startup. Feel free to go down the list and turn off any apps you know you don't use. You can use the sort function at the top to help show you the apps that have the biggest impact on performance. Up next, we are going to customize the start menu. There aren't really many ways to customize the layout at the moment, although more might be added in the future. You can add your favorite apps to the start menu by searching for them in the search bar, then by right-clicking on them, and then by choosing Pin to Start. There are more ways to customize the start menu by going to Settings, then Personalization, and then Start Menu. In here, you can turn on some of the features if you want them, and also choose more apps to appear in the start menu. You can of course organize the apps on the start menu by clicking and holding on them, and then by dragging them to your desired position. We're now going to focus on our sound devices in Windows 11 to make sure they are set up correctly, and we might be able to improve the quality of our sound with some of the options. Head to the sound settings. You can get here by going to the main settings page, then system, and then sound. In here, you will be able to see all of your active sound devices, such as headphones in the output section and your microphone in the input section. Choose your default device by checking the box to the left of it. If you don't see your sound device, scroll down and click on All Sound Devices. Now find your device, click on it, and then choose Allow, and it should now appear for you to set as the default. Back in the sound settings, you'll probably want to change the input level of your microphone, and if you click once on your chosen output device, such as your headphones, you might be able to improve the sound quality by turning on some of the built-in features in Windows 11, such as Enhance Audio. You might be able to find more sound customization options, for example the option to turn on a bass boost by clicking on Advanced. Let's move on to making sure the display is set up correctly in Windows 11, as there are a few settings to potentially change and customize. To get to the display settings in Windows 11, go to the Settings page, then System, and then choose Display. In here, it's worth checking that the display resolution is set to that of your monitor for the best possible quality. Use the drop-down box to change the resolution. Your monitor's resolution should have the words recommended next to it, and it's worth setting it to this to see how it looks. You might also want to change the screen scale in Windows 11. You can do this with the scale drop-down box. The bigger the percentage, the larger items on your screen will appear to be. There are plenty of other display options in here, such as the ability to turn on the nightlight feature in Windows 11, as well as things like HDR if your monitor supports it. Up next, we're going to customize the accent color in Windows 11. This will allow you to change the color of things like the taskbar and start menu. To do this, head to the main settings page by searching for it, and in the settings choose Personalization from the list of options on the left. In here, click on Colors. Now scroll down and choose the color you want the accent color to be in the Colors section. With the color selected, make sure you check the boxes under the colors called Show Accent Color on Start and Taskbar, as well as Show Accent Color on Title Bars and Window Borders. These exact settings are up to you, so feel free to play around with the options. If you scroll up to the top of this page, you might want to turn dark mode on or off as well. You can also change your desktop background and lock screen background in the personalization settings. Next, we can set our favorite apps to the default app for certain files. You might want to set your default browser with this method. Go to Settings and choose Apps. Now choose default apps from the list of options. On this page, you first need to search for the app, such as your browser, that you want to be set as default. You can use the search bar to find it. After finding it, click on it, and then it will open a new page. On this page, you need to go down the list and change each of the options that are set as your current browser to the new one. This can be done by clicking once on the option, and then you will most likely need to click on Switch anyway, and then you should be able to select your new browser and click on OK. We'll now customize the taskbar. To do this, go back to the settings and this time choose personalization from the list of options on the left. In here, scroll down and choose taskbar. Starting from the top, you can choose the main items you want to be displayed on the taskbar, such as search. Feel free to turn any of these on or off. Below this, there are more options that will appear on the right side of the taskbar next to the clock. These are items like the on-screen keyboard. Again, turn these on or off. The taskbar corner overflow section allows you to choose background apps that will always display on the right of the taskbar, such as your browser or Bluetooth status. Play around with these and you'll understand how it works. With the bottom section called taskbar behaviors expanded, you can change the taskbar alignment as well as other settings, for example to make the taskbar hide automatically. Customize these to your preference. You can make any app always show on the taskbar by right-clicking on it whilst it's open, and then by choosing Pin to Taskbar. Keeping your disk or drive with free space is important, and Windows 11 has a feature called Storage Sense, which was in Windows 10 too, but it can be helpful if you set it up. Go to Settings and click on System from the options on the left side. In the System Settings, click on Storage from the list. Now click on Storage Sense to turn it on and also edit the settings. You can customize the settings in here to your preference, but please take care as some of the settings might delete files automatically. For example, files that have been in your recycle bin or downloads folder for more than 30 days. Once you're happy with these settings and you understand them, we can move on. Another feature in Windows 11 is called Focus Assist, and this will allow you to set rules to help manage notifications and interruptions. For example, you can disable notifications when you are working or playing games. Go to Settings, and then System, and then click on Focus Assist. Have a look around these settings and turn on or off some of the features that Focus Assist has, and then set up the times or scenarios of when you want it to enforce the rules. Finally, it's worth setting up your sign-in options and lock screen security as a priority, especially if you have a laptop and use your PC on the go. To set up your sign-in options, go to Settings, then Accounts, and then Sign-in Options. Choose the sign-in type from the list you want to set up and follow the steps. And so those are 10 things to do as soon as you get or update to Windows 11. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. Help support the channel by visiting the store. The link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.